Another life.
I came across a musician the other day
or another, I was pointed to a musician by a colleague at work called Pauline Oliveras, I think she's called, something like that. And she has this this concept that she's been working with, which she calls deep listening. And it's a kind of crossover between musical practice and a kind of enlightenment or meditation practice. And she talks about music for meditation, by which she means not music that you listen to in order to meditate, but kind of music that you make as a meditation. Represents these two complementary modes of listening, two complementary modes of awareness, one of which is focal. So you consider yourself to be, if I get this right, you listen from where you are, and kind of and you act as a kind of focal point for that listening. So whilst I'm standing here, I'm listening to the sounds of a distant aeroplane. But all of these sounds I can hear, I've got kind of relationships to them. They're located in space, in a relational space, and that relationship is with who I am and where I'm standing. Global awareness, on the other hand, doesn't try to disassemble the sounds and locate them in space in quite that way. You just try to listen to all the sounds as a kind of total experience.
talk about listening, which is the fundamental aspect of my work as a composer, as a performer, the community of the moment, so that everyone, everything, every sound is included in what I play, and I acknowledge it all as I am performing. All of the audience that may be present, the total field, then I'm listening deeply, and I'm present in the moment that I'm making the music. This is what creates a kind of community of the moment, so that everyone, everything, every sound is included in what I play, and I acknowledge it all as I'm performing.